In this video, I'm going to talk about what are the best web hosting providers for you as a small business. And no, it's not the most popular, well-known companies that get recommended in all of the lists, videos, and so on. Let's get started. In my opinion, your best options are Cloudways and Hostinger. However, they're best suited for different kinds of businesses. So let me go over what can you expect from these web hosting providers and how your business will specifically benefit from using these web hosting companies over other solutions. Cloudways is probably a company that you've never heard about, and they have quite an interesting business model that allows you to get very effective usage of the money you're spending on hosting. Even though they advertise monthly or yearly prices, it's actually a pay-as-you-go system. Basically, you buy a server and pay based on how much space you take up on that server and how many users you're getting. That means you're never in a situation where you have to pay for resources you're not using. It's just extremely cost-effective. And the monthly prices they have on their plans are actually an estimate of how much it would cost to run that server at maximum efficiency. So you're never gonna have to pay more than that. And if you're not using your hosting at maximum efficiency at all times, you're actually going to pay less than what's shown every month. By clicking the links in the description, you can get a free 3-day trial for any of the Cloudways plans. And there's no hidden catches, you don't need to attach your credit card or something shady like that. But I want to be super transparent here and mention that if you do make a purchase after that, I might make a commission. This allows me to buy and test more web hosting plans and improve the quality and accuracy of my content, and simply continue doing what I'm doing. Since I want to do honest reviews, I can't really take sponsorships, so these affiliate commissions is the best way for me to monetize my content. But enough about that, let's get back to this video. Getting started is quite user-friendly as well. All you need to do is select which content management system you want. For example, I'll use WordPress. Then name your project and server to keep track if you have multiple ones. Select which company you want your virtual private server to come from. I personally found Vulture to be a good choice between price and performance. Then select the server size using this slider. The smaller your server size, the fewer resources you get, and the cheaper it is. The best part is you can actually increase your server size if needed at any point, which means these plans are excellent once your business starts scaling and you need more resources. And finally, choose the physical location of your server. And remember to always choose the server location that's going to be closest to your users, not you, because it's them who's actually gonna be using your website. And by reducing the physical location between the server and the users, you actually make your website faster for that specific user. Once you click launch now, you will have your server automatically configured for you in around 10 minutes. After it's complete, your website will be already online and you can work on the design or content using WordPress. Using Cloudways, you'll get your own private server without all of the complicated setup, and you're in control of resource usage. Also, managing your website is gonna be super easy since Cloudways gives you a unique dashboard or like a control panel. In my opinion, you're getting a very good bundle deal on hardware and software for a bit of an extra cost. And this is worth it because normally, virtual private servers offer really good performance, but they're a nightmare to work with. There is no user interface. You can only communicate to your server via the command prompt or the terminal using commands and coding. It's a nightmare for beginners. Another notable difference that makes Cloudways a better choice for small business owners is the way they handle permissions. For example, if you have an accountant and he needs invoices, you can just give him access to the billing area. That means he will be able to reach invoices by himself, but won't have access to any other aspects of your website. It's a really good utility tool when you have multiple team members, but you don't want for everyone to have the same exact access to your company's website. You get to pick and choose which team members get what kind of permissions when managing your website. And one crucial feature that often gets overlooked when you're managing a business is the email addresses. Cloudways allows you to create professional email addresses. For example, I've created Emit@protechware.com for my business. You can create unlimited email accounts, but you will have to pay around $1 per month for each email box that you plan to add.
You can then check your email box by accessing it through the webmail client, but if you don't want to have an additional email box where you need to go and check everything manually, you can actually link that with your generic Gmail account and have everything in one place. I have a tutorial on how you can do that yourself right here.
And not a major deal, as other web hosting companies also do this as well, but Cloudways does offer a free SSL certificate for every single website you're hosting on your server. You can activate the SSL certificate by simply typing in your website name, and Cloudways will generate everything for you completely automatically. An SSL certificate adds this lock next to your domain name and basically encrypts the connection between the server and your users. But the reason that I think that Cloudways is great for small businesses is because there are no renewal fees, there are no hidden costs, you can always check exactly what you're paying for in the real-time billing section. For example, here it shows that my bill is estimated to be $8.50 next month. If you're interested in the performance, I did a couple of tests and Cloudways was faster than even the most expensive shared web hosting solutions like SiteGround or A2 Hosting. Cloudways loaded my website in 1.6 seconds.
And this is some serious business. These are really good results. To get even close to this kind of performance, you would need to buy plans for around $15 to $20 a month from the top speed-focused web hosting providers like SiteGround or A2 Hosting. Of course, if we're talking about shared web hosting.
But there are several drawbacks if you choose Cloudways. For example, you don't get a domain name. A domain name is your website name. So you need to buy that somewhere else and then attach it to your Cloudways server by pointing the domain to the correct IP address. And if you want for the email service to work, you'll need to edit some settings on your domain as well. This can be done in a couple of minutes if you have the technical knowledge, and Cloudways even has a tutorial on their website, but it's still an inconvenience that you will have to deal with.
And honestly, I could probably list other advantages as well, but I think at this point, you get the point. They're just a really cost-effective, feature-packed web hosting provider that lets you have a lot of control over your team members and your resource usage. I actually plan to upload a full Cloudways review sometime in the future. I just haven't finished editing it yet, but when it's available, if you're watching this in the future, maybe it'll be somewhere around here.
Another company I suggest you strongly consider if you feel like Cloudways is a bit too technical or too expensive for you, or maybe you just won't use the features that it offers, is Hostinger.
I've already talked about Hostinger on this channel a lot. So if you want a super detailed review that I did for 2020, you can find a full Hostinger review right here. But in this video, I'll still go over the top points why I think they're a great solution for small business owners.
First of all, it's the price. Hostinger has some seriously cheap but powerful plans for you to choose from. Their starter plans go for around $1 a month, but you can get that price down to 89 cents a month if you use the links in the description and use the code Emit.Reviews. But as a small business, I would not recommend choosing the shared web hosting plans at all. And go with the cloud hosting plan for $7.45 or the business shared plan for $3.99 if you're really tight on budget.
Keep in mind that these prices are for your first purchase only. When it's time to renew your plans, the cloud hosting goes to around $16 a month and the business plan goes to around $8 a month. It's in your best interest to buy for a longer period of time to get a cheaper price, and I would say it's worth it if you have the money and you know that you'll need the website for a long time.
Once you get a plan, the setup process is extremely simple as well. And as a bonus, you do get to register a domain name for free. So you get absolutely everything you need to start right out of the box. Hostinger also comes with some tools that will help you manage your website and the business side of things easier. For example, Hostinger also has an access manager where you can give different permissions to different team members. And similar to Cloudways, you can create professional-looking email accounts. The main difference being, Hostinger allows you to create as many accounts as you want for free. But these are a bit more prone to getting blocked by spam filters than the Cloudways ones. If you want more secure, less spammy email boxes, they'll also cost around $1 per email per month. If we would look at the performance that Hostinger is offering, the cloud hosting plan is around a full second slower than the Cloudways hosting plan. But 2.2 seconds is still an extremely fast result.
In my opinion, Cloudways has tools that are better suited to manage your business, and you wouldn't need to buy their plans for 3 or 4 years, so there's less upfront costs. You only need to pay a small amount each month. But all of that comes with a little bit of technical knowledge. It's not as easy to use, but still pretty simple. The biggest drawback of Cloudways, I would say, is that a lot of the additional functionality also comes at a price. Hostinger is a good cheaper if you got the money to buy 4 years in advance, easier to use alternative that still offers absolutely everything you need to manage a successful website on a budget. A lot of people would recommend you use a SiteGround, a Bluehost or Hostgator, but in my opinion, these either cost too much, don't offer enough, or lack the performance and scalability for your business. So if you're ready to get started and create a website for your small business, I recommend you choose Cloudways and get the free 3-day trial to try it out, see if it's the right choice for you. You can get that by using the links in the description down below. And if you want to go with a simpler solution right out of the box that's not gonna cost you a lot of money, then you can choose Hostinger. I also have Hostinger coupon codes in the description down below. My name's Emit, and as always, good luck creating your websites.